Hello and welcome to Zandvoort for the start of the second half of the F2 season, coming off the back of the summer break and the Belgium Grand Prix, where we didn't have the best of weekends. We're looking to bounce back after what happened there. We're going to be starting P8 for the sprint race. We put it third for the feature later on this weekend. This is our qualifying lap then. It was a fairly decent one, just not enough to grab pole, but we did get it early on in the start of qualifying. A good lap early on, but we did start to drop back later on. But unfortunately, our last lap was terrible. We were only just down on our time. We found a couple of hundredths, but it wasn't enough. So we're going to be starting P8 for the sprint. So here we go then, the five red lights come on ahead of us and we're racing for the sprint here at Zandvoort. We've got a fairly decent start. We're going to go into the middle, we've gained a couple of places. We're now going to try and use the bank and sweep around the outside of a couple of cars. We can quite do that. We're looking to the inside, there's no way through there. We're going to go around the outside though of them, nearly into the side of them. We're going to push them wide, all the way very wide, and gain that position. We've gained a couple of places at the start. It's been fairly decent, to say the best of things. So we're going to skip on all the way to the end of lap 6. We could just not find a way past Jack Doohan, or even to get close enough to him really. But we go on to lap 7 now. We were just stuck, but we're going to have a look to the outside, try and get the exit, which looks like we've got a decent one just ahead of us. We're going to look to the inside. We're now going to go later on the round the outside of the bank corner. We've got a great exit this time. We're on the inside of Jack Doohan. We're side by side. We're briefly ahead, and now we're fully ahead of Jack Doohan. Great move. It's been waiting, but finally we've got it done. Now we're on a roll. We're on the back of Roman Stanek, and we're going to send it down the inside of him and onto the podium for the sprint race. Up ahead is Vesti. There's 6-7 laps to go in this one. Can we catch our fellow junior Mercedes driver, a teammate? We're all over the back of him now as we are on the final lap of the sprint. I feel like we could have maybe won this race. We still can win it, but it's going to be difficult as we look to the outside of Vesti. We're looking to do what we did with Jack Doohan and get a good launch off the turn right, and that's exactly what we've done. And we take P2 off of Vesti on the final lap of this sprint race. For sure, he's going to win it. We're too far back to have a go on him. And here he is, rounds the final bank corner. He sees the line, he crosses it, but we are going to come home for a great P2. So that's been the sprint race, a little bit dull. It came to life at the end. We could have maybe won that if we didn't spend so long trying to find a way past Jack Doohan. It's some good points, especially after Spa. P2 isn't a bad result. It's helped us in the championship as well, of course. We lost a lot of points to Tate Bocher, and he's finished this sprint all the way down in 12th. We've gained some points back on him. Down at the back is Jack Crawford, who finishes stone dead last. So that's been sprint. Let's go to the main event, the feature race.
It is the Formula 2 race. It is time to introduce you to Alex Brundle. I'm Alex Jakes, and we've got changeable weather out there today. That's making for some nervous team personnel down in the paddock, down in the pit lane.
Well, uncertainty is what strategy is all about, but it absolves the teams from the responsibility of running both compounds of tyre. They might have to use that wet tyre, of course. And then the question is, where do those crossovers lie between the wet and dry conditions?
A fantastic effort from Victor Martins yesterday puts him on pole position, with Jayan Deruvilla alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Brown, Hauger, Isaac Hadjar, Doohan, Fittipaldi, Vesti, Vachon, Roman Stanek, Leclerc, Novalak, Teo Pourchaire, Kushmini, Behrmann, Correa, Maloney, Amaury Cordiel, Benavides, Bochon, Crawford, and Ayumu Owasa completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
So we're here on the grid then ahead of the feature race. We're doing a soft to medium. We're not doing the old tyre strategy. I think we've learned that that doesn't really work after what happened in Spa. So we're going to be starting on the softs, going to the mediums, and let's see what happens. We need to get back to some form. But the lights go out and we're underway, and we've got a fairly decent start. It's a good start by those in front. Now we're on the outside of Derivola. We're trying to keep it pinned round the outside. He looks like he's got a better exit, but he can't keep it pinned. We're up into B2. Victor Martins leads the Dutch feature race. We go a bit deep. Derivola tries to have a look at our inside, but we managed to get the exit to pull away from him. As we're all over the back now of Victor Martins, lap 6, we're looking to do what we did to Vesti and doing in the sprint race, but we're a little bit too far back this time to have a go, but we've got a fairly decent run there. Now though, onto the end of lap 6 and the start of lap 7, we're getting closer and closer to the Alpine Academy driver, and we send it to the inside and we take the lead of the feature race. It's been a while since we've been able to say that, but we're in the lead. Now, can we stay in the lead? There is rain predicted towards the end of this feature race. So if we can build a gap whilst we can, that would have been great, but we didn't. And skipping on to the end of lap 9, and we are in to make our one and only stop of the day, and followed in by a lot of cars. Victor Martins managed to stick to the back of us as we go off the softs and on to the mediums. It's a fairly quick stop. All things considered, 4.1 seconds. It's a very good stop. We haven't lost any places. We're still right at the front of the truddy train as we come out of the pits now. And now it's time to get the hammer down as we're looking to overcut Victor Martins and try and get ahead in these open couple laps, trying to heat up the tyres as quickly as we can and find some of that pace. It's at the end of lap 10. Here we go down the straight. It is Dennis Hauger. He's going for a move on us. He's going to the inside of us. He's backed out of that one. We've run a bit wide. There's Martins. Martins has beat us out. Hauger's on the inside of us. And as we go through the corner, we've beached it on the curb. We're going through the gravel. We're off the track. We're off the track. We've lost loads of places there. It's all gone wrong in a split second. Here in the feature race, we've lost multiple positions. We already lost out to Martins. It's all gone wrong. We've gone through a lucky trip through the gravel. This is what happened from Jack Doohan's point of view. We just lost the back end. We just beached it on the curb going into turn two, and just dropped it. And now this is Vesti's point of view, who we very nearly made contact with. Coming back onto the track, he gets us round the outside. And now it's just like it was in the sprint. We're hunting down Vesti. And it was looking good briefly in this race. We took the lead for a while down the inside of Vesti. We get him back. We just need to refocus and go again. But the rain is on its way. It is coming down. We're on the back of Fittipaldi. There is the rain. It has arrived with just 3 laps to go, but it is coming down very, very heavy as well. But there's no point pitting. There's only so little laps left. What's the point? We're just going to have to survive on these final couple of laps. If you can stick with me as we nearly drop the back end, and you can see the spray now coming off the tyres. It is so wet. We are skating. This track is an ice rink. But we're just about staying with Fittipaldi. But eventually, they're fixed this now. But the AI are too strong in these kind of conditions when they really shouldn't be, and we're really struggling to keep the car on a straight line. It's just like it was in the feature race at Silverstone, where we boxed that day for wet tyres. We went from pole to last in about half a lap that day, and there's a bit of a trail falling behind us now. Lap 19, it is so wet out there, you can see the correcting overs here. We've got so little grip, and that's Vesti who's nearly dropped it as well. And that's Ajax Hajar, who's gone off the track and a little trip through the gravel. Everyone is struggling now. This is a replay of Vesti. We ran a bit wide, we nearly dropped it, and then Vesti here just absolutely nothing, just drops it all on his own. Very well held as well. You can see us all over the place snaking around just in front of Vesti as well, and then he's still losing it. The AI is struggling as well, but not as much as we are. This is Ajax Hajar's point of view. I think he may have got a little bit scared off the road by Vesti, but he just seemed to lock that right front and go straight on, not quite the gravel, but very nearly, and he's lost a lot of places. But now, the end of lap 19, we are struggling so much, as we will go now onto the final lap of this feature race. It must have been a very dramatic feature race. It was looking good for a while as we've gone wide. We've nearly made contact with Vesti. Vesti's going to do what we did to him in the sprint race and take us on the final lap of this feature race. He gets payback after we did that in the sprints, and we are now skated. He's pulled a very big gap so far, has Vesti, and as we skip on towards the end of the lap, you can see that gap now as we're drifting, Tokyo drift style, round that corner. But this man, Victor Martens, has managed the conditions to perfection. We overtook him early on, but he is going to win the feature race here at Zandvoort. There is Vesti, you can see the gap he pulled on the final lap, but we are going to come home for some points. It's a bit more successful than Spa, but we're going to come home for a very tricky P7.
Have you seen one quite as dominant as that, Jakesy? Not sure I have. They led every single lap of that one, lights to flag.
An amazing race today, and a very well-deserved one too. The team worked very hard to get exactly the right setup out of the F2 car. It works for them, and the results speak for themselves. ARTGP winners today.
Well, I'm not quite sure what race Alex Brundle watched, but Victor Martens did not lead every single lap of that. I'm pretty sure I remember leading a couple of those laps. But Victor Martens is the winner. Dennis Howell got P2. Jack Doohan completing the podium. Fair play to Martens, drove very well. We had him at one point. The overcut worked brilliantly for him, but I think we could have had him back if we hadn't have beached on the curb and gone through the gravel. A P7 for us, I think all things considered, after that mistake, is pretty good. I think if it hadn't have rained, we could have got Fittipaldi, but the AI is just too strong in these kind of conditions. So in terms of the Drivers' Championship now, the gap was down after Spa to 14 points. We've now got it back up to 30. There's only 4 races left. 2 race weekends. We've got Monza next time out and the grand finale in Abu Dhabi. It's still going to be tight in the World Championship between us and Teo Pagès. I feel like we haven't really raced him on the track though this season. And it is Ralph Bochon who is bottom of the pile, along with Jack Crawford. Both of them still yet to score this season. In terms of the constructors then, and the gap has been cut down because of Victor Martins' good weekend. It was 15 points after Spa, it's now just 4. That big lead we had very early on in the season has shrunk very quickly. I think we can do the constructors and the drivers. A very mixed weekend. Toto Wolf wasn't happy after Spa. He might not be too happy after this weekend as well. He still says we're in for a shout of a Formula One seat next season, but we need to bounce back at Monza, and I'll see you then. Goodbye.